So Tim, this is the Open Engineering Lab. It's a brand bright new shiny facility that you're in charge of. Can you tell me a little bit about what goes on in here?
Absolutely. We've just added an electronics flavour to our general engineering degree. That starts in September, and this lab has the practical work for that course in it.
There are six instruments here. Is that part of the module then that the students will be doing?
Yes. On our course, we're going to take students through the process of system-level thinking in electronics. We want to make them well-rounded engineers, and that means we need to start them off with sensing. So they're going to use this board here to look at light and strain, and then we're going to take them to a board that, believe it or not, models what happens when an autonomous car comes up to a junction and needs to figure out which way to go and what obstacles to avoid.
So a smart car in real life.
Absolutely. So the students will get to play with that, and then once they've understood how to get information from the real world, we need to show them how to make decisions with it. So we're going to let them loose on this digital board, and that shows them how you can decide and choose courses of action. And once they've done that, they then have to make those courses of action real. So we bring them over to this board, which has different types of motors on it that represent all the different ways you might want to control something in the real world. And if you put those three things together, the sensing, the logic, and the actuators, then even your wildest imaginations can take on practical form.
So we've got the experiments, but there doesn't appear to be a lot of room for students in here, Tim. How are you going to make that work? Well,
absolutely. Look, I'm actually going to lock the door. I'm not even going to let the students into the room at all. Instead, they're going to access it using a web browser. So we've got some cameras here so that they can see the equipment. We've squeezed every last drop of delay out of that video feed, and the control that they'll have is absolute. They'll be able to do everything they need to do with the equipment, and it's going to be happening in real time, just as it was if they were in the room.
All over the world?
Absolutely. I was in Austin last week, and I swear the link there is just about as fast as it is from my office.
That's brilliant. So there's just the six instruments here. But I believe that around the corner, you've got things going on a grander scale.
Absolutely. The very first experiment's a pendulum, and the intent behind that is to make a somewhat abstract concept of a sine wave take on a concrete practical form, just to get students used to it so we can go forward into the abstract world of electronics on a solid foundation. And here we have 30 of them all laid out.
This is amazing. So you're telling me that an individual student is operating their machine from their own home?
Absolutely. Each of these experiments will belong to the student for a whole hour or more slots if they wish, and that means they can do what they like with it for that whole time.
How many students can you cater for then?
Well, we've got 11 racks like this one, and that means when we're up and running at full strength with other courses involved, we will be able to serve 4,752 individual hour-long experiments in a single day.
That's remarkable. What made you then bring this technology in particular to the OU?
Well, the thing that connects students to this is the same sort of thing that's going on in the world. It's a connected world now, so our students are actually at the vanguard of understanding how to operate in an engineering environment where they're probably not going to be in the same time zone as their collaborators, let alone the same building.
Tim, it's brilliant, and I'm definitely going to come back and see you again when the whole place is up and running.
Fantastic.